Welcome. In this video, we'll see the instructions for rotate and some of the miscellaneous instructions present in PIC16F877 microcontroller. So the first instruction is RLF. So RLF stands for rotate left file through carry. So whatever value or data is present in the file register, that will be rotated on left side through carry. So the syntax for the instruction is RLF F, D. So this F is the file register. It can be any memory location, that is RAM memory location, or it can be any SFR. And this D is the destination bit. So whenever we execute this instruction RLF F, D, at that time, whatever value is present in this file register, that will be rotated on left side by 1 bit position. And the result will be stored depending on the status of this destination bit. If this bit is 0, then the result will be stored in working register, and if this bit is 1, then the result will be stored in the same file register. So the status affected is carry flag, and that is how the instruction will work. Next instruction is RRF. So this RRF instruction is used to rotate the file register through carry on right side. So the syntax for this instruction is RRF F, D. Again, F is any file register, it can be any memory location, or it can be any SFR. Again, D is the destination bit. So the status affected is only carry flag. So again, the value which is present in the file register, that will be rotated on right side by 1 bit position, and the whatever result is generated, that result will be stored either in working register or in the file register depending on the status of this D or the destination bit. Now one thing to note is that there is no shift right or shift left instruction available in PIC16F877. So if we want to perform the shift operation, then we have to make the carry flag 0 and then we have to rotate the data. So every time we have to clear the carry flag and then we have to rotate the data. So in this way we can perform the shifting operation. So the difference between the rotate and shift operation is that in case of rotate right, for example, the data will be rotated on right side by 1 bit position. In that case, the LSB bit present in the file register will be copied to the carry flag, and the bit present in carry flag will be copied to the MSB bit of the file register. So in that way, the right rotate operation will work. And in case of rotate left, the MSB bit present in the file register will be copied to carry flag, and the carry flag will be copied to the LSB bit position of the file register. And in that way, the data will be rotated. But in case of shifting, whenever we shift anything on left side, the LSB bit of the file register should have 0. And whenever we shift anything on right side, the MSB bit of the file register should have 0. So if the shifting instructions are not available, we have to make use of the rotate instructions for performing the shifting operation. And for this, we have to make the carry flag 0 and then perform the rotate operation. So for every shifting operation, we have to first of all clear the carry flag, again perform rotate instruction, we have to clear the carry flag, perform rotate operation, and so on. So some miscellaneous instructions are available, like NOP. So NOP is called as no operation. So it is just used to kill the time, and it is used for creating a small, very small delay. So we can use this multiple NOP instructions to create a small delay. And last instruction is sleep instruction. So using this instruction, the chip goes in sleep mode, that or it is also called as standby mode. So it is not having any operand, so it is just sleep. Then whenever this instruction is executed, the watchdog timer is cleared. Then the watchdog timer prescaler is also made equal to 0. And at the same time, the T0 bar bit, which is present in the status register, that is made equal to 1. And this PD bar bit, which is again present in status register, that is made equal to 0. So this indicates that the device is in power down mode or in sleep mode. So the status affected are these two bits, that is T0 bar and PD bar, which are present in status register. So that is how the sleep instruction will be used. So this, whenever we want to consume less amount of power, or whenever the CPU is not going to do any work, at that time we can put the CPU in sleep mode to have minimum power consumption. So that is about the instruction set of PIC16F877. In the next video, we'll see the addressing modes available in PIC16F877. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.